Hello, my name is Dinorah Delfin. I'm a multimedia artist and a transhumanist activist. Today, I'm going to challenge your mind and set you on a path to become the best version of yourself. I'm going to show you how you can live radically longer, healthier, and more fulfilling lives, and how you can unleash the artist and activist within you and help the world transition into the next great era of human civilization. Now, close your eyes. Imagine you're an artist and you have been commissioned to create a painting to inspire humanity. Let your imagination speak to you for a moment. What would the world be like if everyone were to achieve profound self-knowledge and self-mastery? What would the world be like if everyone were to agree on the nature of reality? What would the world be like if everyone were to live in abundance? Now, open your eyes. The world that you imagine probably looks like some kind of utopian paradise, a place where there is significantly less suffering and people are free to explore any lifestyle they desire. Some of you probably think that this could never be possible, or perhaps even undesirable, because a life without challenges seems purposeless. But what if I tell you, not only a paradise on earth is possible, and no matter how sophisticated humanity becomes, we will never run out of challenges and opportunities. Envisioning desirable futures is not only exciting, but they also have important and practical everyday applications. Just like dystopian futuristic movies warn us about situations we wish to prevent, the narratives we envision can literally shape our well-being, our consciousness, and the futures we manifest. In a recent TED Talk by Daisy Robinson, a Harvard University scientist who focuses on gene editing and developmental biology, explains that the quality of our thoughts affects our body's cellular configuration, making us sick or healthy. She says, the quality of our thoughts can literally kill us. To imagine utopian narratives not only can improve our physical and mental well-being while allowing us to exercise critical thinking, but they also condition our consciousness to manifest more desirable futures. So, how does one transition from imagining exciting futures to actually manifesting them when humans are so quick to judge and disagree with one another? The human mind has been conditioned for millions of years to treat one another with ambivalence. Natural systems are in undeniable crisis, because we view ourselves as being separate from nature, and billions suffer and also die from starvation, preventable diseases, natural catastrophes, and all kinds of horrific crimes against nature and humanity, because we lack a universal moral foundation to guide our values. While it is important to help the less fortunate and to speak up against injustice, the greatest service to the world is that of self-knowledge, as it leads to a better understanding of others and the universe. Growing up, I always wanted to be a scientist. This journey took me to many places, and eventually I realized that through the creative process, I could also explore the very same existential questions that have been haunting me since I was a child. In 2007, I created a pixelated profile of a girl in 3D. A sculptural painting which represents the idea of a hybrid being, both digital and physical, alluding to a future offspring, a divine crossbreed between matter and soul. In 2009, I created a series of self-portraits, which I named Holy. This series represents the difficult but cathartic journey within. In 2011, I created an experimental short video, Fossil Food, The Age of World Suicide, a monologue that reflects on ethical and environmental issues following my participation at the Occupy Wall Street movement. In 2013, I created Odyssey Metal, a meaningful choreography, a video collage about the need to integrate the best of Eastern and Western wisdom in the pursuit of a universal value system. In 2017, I wrote a personal prayer, which I named Mantra Manifesto Capitalista. This poem reflects on the power of intentions in light of a new era of self-directed evolution. This year, I started a series of fictional and non-fictional writings, which I'm adapting into multimedia production. Making art is not only exciting, but has taught me that the creative process is one of the most powerful tools for self-transformation and for understanding the mysteries and complexities of humans, planet Earth, and the universe. We are in the early stages of an epic paradigmatic shift, the beginning of what's called the fourth industrial revolution, which is integrating for the first time biological, physical, and man-made systems. For the first time in our history, we are building a robust and sophisticated scientific foundation for the effect of mindfulness on the brain, on the human genome, and on biological aging. Digital technologies are empowering people like never before, and are drastically changing the nature of biology. Companies like Microsoft, Google, and the Chan Zuckerberg Initiative are investing billions of dollars to eliminate all diseases within our children's lifetime. This means that we will radically increase human lifespan to possibly hundreds of years. What will this mean to the way we think of ourselves? To the way we think of relationships, of happiness, of love, of purpose, of careers? People often complain life is too short. We are overworked, underpaid, stretched thin and burnt out. People are tired of pity fighting. Stress and anxiety are literally killing us. People want longer lives with more purpose, more joy, more indulgence, more time to slow down. Modern society is aching to transcend itself. Transhumanism is a philosophical and cultural revolution, one that advocates for the radical improvement of the human condition and for the safe and ethical use of advanced technologies. Even though we have the challenges of today, we must also set the foundation for tomorrow and protect our Earth, which has taught us all we know. Humanity is facing new challenges, and depending on how we approach them, this could mean the survival or extinction of the human species. Intelligent design, critical thinking, vision, creativity, balance are all crucial values in the readaptation of educational and economic systems to be able to maximize efficiency and, most importantly, the well-being for the most people. The well-being for the most people depends on how efficiently we manage resources on a large scale with the least disruption to natural ecosystems. Challenges related to man-made intelligence and its ethical implications are reminding us that a lack of better values to guide our actions is humanity's greatest existential risk. Challenges related to morphological freedom are reminding us that it is a human responsibility and a right to master our own self-actualization and enlightenment. Transhumanist politics are also reminding us that integrating sciences and the humanities are crucial to establishing intelligent infrastructure to prepare for humanity's next technological transition. Someone said, no one steps in the same river twice. The human mind is profoundly adaptable. Every second, every day, is an opportunity for radical transformation and a radical new beginning. What we were yesterday doesn't dictate what we can be tomorrow. We are already capable of the unbelievable. We are already immortal in many ways. As the human mind learns to better know itself and awakens, it will be able to learn to reconfigure its relationship to others, to work, to all its values, and to the planet. Intelligent life is the product of 4.6 billion years of a delicate and complex co-creation between life and Earth, with humans representing the very last speck of this evolution. Some say that intelligent life, once it evolves, it extinguishes quickly. Humans are an evolutionary miracle with the potential to thrive through the cosmos or become another species that once inhabited the Earth. While it is important to have strong convictions, it is equally as important to challenge preconceived ideas of what it means to be human. We owe it to Mother Earth to transcend the boundaries of our intellectual, emotional, and spiritual limitations. We all have the choice to tune in to the right messages and learn from those that don't serve us. While political instability and the evils of power and ignorance threaten the survival of the human species and everything we treasure, I invite you to master your own creative process and help humanity transition into a kinder, more egalitarian future, and to use the power of our technologies, to disseminate messages of radical mindfulness and profound self-transformation. Thank you.